Hey everybody, it's David and I'm back with another video. I know it's been a very long time, but I just really haven't felt like putting videos out. But now I feel like I am, and I feel like I want to. So I'm going to start with a contest video for Ron Haggerty's Vinyl Pasta channel. I think that's what the title of his channel is now. But he wanted us to pick our favorite year in music and answer questions about that year. So I picked 1993. I really like that. I mean, a lot of good stuff came out that year. When I started looking at this, I didn't realize how much good stuff came out that year. Get into it. Here's the first one, is an overrated album. This one was really hard to pick because I just like everything that I listen to, but then when I got to thinking about it, this album, people like it, but I mean, I like it too. I mean, there's some good stuff, but it's not as good as their debut, and it's definitely not as good as their next album, which was Great Links. But that's why I picked PFR and Goldie's Last Day. I know it's that's Goldie there for some reason they called it Goldie's Last Day. I don't know. It's not my favorite song off the album. But, you know, whatever. You know, it's not horrible. You know. I mean, it's got, let's see, it's got Walk Away From Love, That Kind of Love, By Myself, Dying Man, Spinning Around, and Wait For The Sun. Those are the really good standout tracks on that album. But, like I said, it just wasn't as good as their debut, and it wasn't as good as their third one, which, if you can hear the music in the background, that is their third album, Great Links. So, it's a lot better than, than the Goldie's Last Day. Anyway, an underrated album. This one was kind of hard to pick too, but it's again one of my very favorite albums from this group. I mean, I can't say it's the first album that I listened to from them, but they've been around for a very long time, and not a lot of people talk about this album, and I think it's a really good one, and that's Wake Up Call from Petra. And it's got a lot of really good songs on it. Midnight Oil, Good News, Strong Convictions, He's Been In My Shoes, Underneath the Blood is probably like one of my favorite songs off this album. Then, you know, Believer Indeed, Marks of the Cross, and Just Reach Out. And if you go back and you listen to when this particular lineup started working on Petra albums, you know, with John Schlitt, Louis Weaver, John Lowry, Bob Hartman, and Ronnie Cates, they put, to me, they put the best albums out of Petra when those five guys were together. But that's Petra. Wake Up Call is an underrated album. Let's see. The next up is a comeback album, which this one was kind of difficult too, but I kind of finally went with this group, and this group will show up again with this same album in my top five. Just a heads up. But I picked this one because in 91 they released an album called Living Proof on Word Records. The next year in 92 they released their greatest hits called One Heart at a Time on Word. Then they came back with this album but on a different record label. So that's why I'm kind of calling it a comeback album, because when a group changes record labels, you kind of wonder, like, okay, are they going to be the same that they were, you know, in the last one? Are they going to be better? Are they going to be worse? What? Well, they came out of the box and kicked some butt with this album. And that's a new song, All Around the World. It's on the Benson record label. If you're not familiar with Benson, they had probably their biggest one that they had on there was For Him. And this group is kind of like For Him. Their vocal group like For Him was. But this album, actually, this is the album that I discovered new song on. Oh man, it was just, which is awesome, because I remember back then you'd go to the Christian bookstore and you'd buy like four tapes or CDs and you get a free CD. Well, one of them was a Benson music sampler, and they had a whole bunch of other groups on there. They even at one point they had DeGarmo and Key on their label. They had I think one of the Benson sampler CDs had Tamplin on it, you know, and then they had Three Crosses. They had a whole bunch of other people on it, but I don't have a lot of time to go into that. Anyway, so I picked it up, and their song It's a Wonderful Life was on that CD, and I was like, wow, this group sounds awesome. So, you know, I went, started getting into their stuff and realizing they had been around since, like, the 70s. So I'm like, wow. And, so, this is, like, the first album I discovered them on. You know, it's really, really good album. It's a Wonderful Life, More God, All Around the World. They even redid Reach Out, I'll Be There. I think that was a really good one. Yeah. Sorry. And, you know, Reach Out, they redid that and they did a cover of that. Fields of Faith, Fingertips and Noses, and they even got a song on here called Hero of the Faith, which was written for Billy Graham. It's a really good song. That's my comeback album, new song, All Around the World. For debut album, it is Point of Grace. Now, they are a vocal group made up of women. Nothing wrong with that, you know. This album is awesome. This is the first album I ever heard from them, which was their debut. So, they have been with them since the very beginning, and they're still putting stuff out. There's only three of them now, but still making some good music. See, this one's got I'll Be Believing, One More Broken Heart, Jesus Will Still Be There, Faith, Hope, and Love, and This Day. So, I mean, a lot. I mean, it's just great. All 11 songs are really good. So, and they're actually a really good group. Still around today. So that's Point of Grace with the best debut album of 1993. Alright, now my wish list album. I just have really one, and that's Wes King, The Robe. And it's just, if you don't know who Wes King is, he's like a pop, kind of folky sometimes, but that's the only one I have from that year. I even looked through Discogs and saw, you know, my want list, and that's the only one that was from 1993. So, okay, so the top five now, my top five albums of 1993. Okay, again, number five is New Songs, Arms Around the World. I already talked about this album, but came in number five for the whole entire year. Number four is Jeff Moore in the Distance, Evolution. Just an awesome album. Sorry about all the coughing. I don't know what's up with me. All of a sudden, I can't stop coughing. But there's Evolution from Jeff Moore in the Distance. Evolution Redefined, Life Together, Live to Tell. They redid Larry Norman's Why Should the Devil Have All the Good Music on this album. That's one of my favorite songs off this album. So that's Jeff Moore in the Distance, Evolution, number four. Number three is Old School Christian Rap, DOC, Pulling No Punches. I'll tell you, I didn't know this group was around until on one of the, not on the Benson sampler, but on a different one. All the record labels really put them out all the time at that time, you know, at that time. If this one was on a Star Song sampler. Because that time, the other group was on Star Song too. But when I heard the hip hop body slam hard rock Holy Spirit jam, God Gave Rock and Roll to You featuring Bride, I was a fan of DOC. I was like, wow, these guys are cool. And then I picked up this album and I just loved the entire album. There's We Got It. Then, of course, the hip-hop, body slam, hard rock, Holy Spirit jam, God Gave Rock and Roll to You. There's Old Time Way, Why You Won't Serve the Lord, Keep On Looking Up, How That Sound, Love Can Bring You Back, Innocent Love, Pulling No Punches. I mean, all the way around. This album is just awesome. If these last two were not in this, came out this year in 1993, this one would definitely be number one. But this is number three, DOC Pulling No Punches. Number two, I have the original, but I just picked up the gold disc edition, so, Guardian, Miracle Mile. Here's the original cover, without the gold disc thing, but one of my favorite Guardian albums. The first time I ever heard Guardian was with this album, because I remember walking through the Christian bookstore and looking at that cover and going, wow, that cover is awesome looking. And I picked it up, bought it, loved it. And to tell you how long ago it was, I bought it on cassette. It was before I even had CDs. I bought this on cassette. So that's number two, Guardian. Miracle Mile. There you go. Number one, and I've been listening to this group since the very beginning, so, but when this album came out, man, they took off. They took off big time. They don't do music anymore, which kind of sucks, because everything they put out was awesome. But that is Audio Adrenaline, Don't Censor Me. Oh man, this album, it just kicks butt. My favorite Audio Adrenaline album. I mean, it's just an awesome album. Can't Take God Away. AKA Public School. Soulmate. My Worldview featuring Kevin Max from DC Talk. Their biggest hit ever, Big House, was on this album. Jesus and the California Kid. That one, I like that one, because it made them sound like the Beach Boys, and it was kind of, it was cool. Then Don't Censor Me, We're a Band, Rest Easy, Scum Sweetheart, top to bottom, awesome, awesome album. So there you go, Ron. I hope that's good enough. Wow, almost 20 minutes. Well, so if you guys don't know Ron Haggerty, look up, go check out Ron Haggerty's Vinyl Pasta. Awesome guy, awesome channel. He's into everything. He's into jazz, country, rock, heavy metal, death metal. And he's a good Christian guy. That's the main reason that I like his channel, is because he's a good Christian dude. Well, that's it. Have a good day.